It's a whole new group coming in with Joe Douglas as the GM. They have one draft, you know, under their belt, but they have so much more work to do. They've got four first-round picks in the next 2 years, and it's going to take time. So what they decide to do, whether it's trading the number one overall pick, if that's where they wind up in the upcoming draft, or trading Sam Darnold, I think Darnold will be in a good spot in a couple of years, but it's going to take more time.
Keyshawn, J. Will, and Zubin is presented by Progressive Insurance. All guests join us on the Shell Pennzoil Performance Line. What would
Listen
you
to
do?
You, Key. I'm so impressed.
Hey, man, he loves doing that read. He loves doing it.
Okay. You one of those guys, right? Well, just play football. No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, stop it.
I'm just kidding. I couldn't do it.
There's no chance I could do it. I would mess it up every day.
Ty, you and I both were in L.A. watching Sam 3 years ago in the pouring down rain at his pro day. So we know what he could potentially be. What would you do, Todd, if you had the number one overall pick and Justin Fields and Trevor Lawrence is sitting there?
I haven't talked to Joe about it, Joe Douglas, the GM. But if I knew that Sam still had the confidence and physically that he wasn't too beaten up, I would stick with him. And I would take these four first round picks. I would actually trade if we're drafting number one overall. I would trade the pick, get multiple first rounders, and stack them up over the next 2 years. And basically know that it's not going to be in 2021, but it's going to be in 2022, where we now have 4 or 5 first rounders, probably 7 or 8 guys in the first 3 rounds in these 2 drafts. And now I have guys around Sam. That's what I would do. But if, you know, I'm not in the building every day, so I don't know what's going on with Sam. I don't know if he's exhausted from everything he's been through. I don't know if his confidence is down. And if that's the case, then you trade him and you bring in Trevor Lawrence and you take him at the number one overall pick. I mean, the Clemson quarterback, Justin Fields, is having a phenomenal year. And you heard David Pollack earlier, and I think there's not a big gap between the two. But I would take Trevor Lawrence number one overall if you decided to move on from Sam.
Why every single year, for the most part, Todd, when the number one selection comes up, it's always once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to take this guy, or once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to take that guy. But the hit rate on the number one overalls is missed far many times than actually hitting. But we still believe that Trevor Lawrence is a once-in-a-lifetime generational-type quarterback. When we've seen guys go at number one overall – and it didn't work out like that. So you're taking a chance.
Yeah, I mean, just for perspective, it's right now Trevor Lawrence has the highest grade on a quarterback or player that I've given since Andrew Luck in 2012. So it's a long time. And the hit rate is getting higher if you really look at it. You know, I know Jared Goff is a good quarterback. He's not exceptional. Carson Wentz has had the injuries and he's struggling. But you look at the last couple of years, I mean, there have been a lot of really good quarterbacks. Kyler Murray, what he's doing. You know, you look at what these young quarterbacks are doing and coming in. I mean, it's really impressive. So there used to be a higher miss rate. I think it's getting better and better each year. I think the quarterback development is so much better than it used to be, starting when they're like in junior high school and all the way up with the 7-on-7s and the camps that they go to. And you know everything that goes on, especially out in California. But I get it. But to me, Trevor Lawrence is different. He really is. He's different. Justin Fields is developing. He's not there yet, but he is developing, and he's completing more than 80% of his throws this year. I mean, in 3 games, he has been phenomenal. So we have 2 great quarterbacks in this class. Then there's Trey Lance from North Dakota State. Then there's Zach Wilson from BYU, who might not come out early, but he's been outstanding. He extends plays, and he's everything that you look for. And after that, Mac Jones from Alabama. So there are 5 quarterbacks that could be first-round picks this year. And I get it. There's always going to be some misses, but these quarterbacks are getting better and better each year, in my opinion.
It'll be interesting. The road to April 29th, 2021. It's never too early. Hopefully we'll have fans back. It won't be virtual. I know Todd missed last year's draft, and we really missed you. So we're looking forward to next April. Back the way it used to be, the 3-day extravaganza, and nobody studies it like Todd. Todd, can't wait to next spring. We'll see what happens with Lawrence and Fields and Wilson and Lance and Jones. All of those guys we certainly need to keep an eye on. Thank you, Todd.
Todd.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus right now.